Hello, and welcome to another Masters of Disney Adventures video. If you're wondering why we look like this.
I dyed my hair.
A week after Halloween. Obviously it's filmed
on Halloween.
On Halloween, so these two, as you can probably guess, are off out trick-or-treating after this. And I just look scary as I am, so.
Yeah, he doesn't need a costume.
No. So, on with the news then. First up, we've got the new movie Lightyear, which is basically the backstory of how Buzz Lightyear travelled from infinity and beyond.
Mm-hmm.
So it does look really interesting. The way it's filmed, I don't know, just from the trailers, it just looks really, really good. So, yeah, so basically just shows literally how he travelled through space and yeah, became the Buzz Lightyear we know on Toy Story.
Cool.
So yeah, very much looking forward to that.
When's that out?
So that's out on June the 17th in cinemas.
Okay.
So that's obviously American. I think they're pretty much a similar sort of time for America and Britain, aren't they?
It's not too far apart, so
something to look forward to next year.
So. I'll have to take her this year on her first trip to the cinema for that one, maybe.
Yeah, would you like to see Buzz Lightyear?
Yeah. I love Buzz Lightyear.
Buzz Lightyear.
Oh, yeah. I actually have a really mini toy of Buzz Lightyear, don't I?
You do, yeah. You got that from Disney World, didn't you?
Oh, yeah.
And then, moving on, the Main Street Electrical Parade is back at Disneyland.
Oh, I thought you were going to say Disney World then.
I know, I wish it was. I wish it was. When it was at Disney World, I think we saw it back in 2012, wasn't it?
Yeah.
And it finished not long after that.
Yeah.
So that was kind of like...
I mean, it was quite dated, so...
Yeah, but it's still fun. It was something to do at night time.
Yeah, I suppose.
Before the fireworks.
Mm-hmm.
So, it's just sad that it's not around, but glad it's back at Disneyland. So one day we could end up back in... Well, back, say back. We could end up going to Disneyland one day and actually see it.
So. That Disneyland in California.
California, yes. Yeah. Well, where it's been there... For a while, hasn't it? I presume it finished just before COVID, from what I can recall.
Probably. Blooming COVID.
Yeah.
Got around everywhere.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's good to see that back. I mean, we do have something similar at Disney World. The
water
pontoon type things, yeah.
What's it called? The pageant, isn't it?
Yeah.
The water pageant.
Yeah, that's the one. Which normally occurs just after... The fireworks show, isn't it?
Mm.
Yeah, so when you're on the I remember we were on the ferry coming out after the fireworks.
Yeah,
we were all there lining up. I think if you have a slight delay on going out, as long as you don't leave the park straight away,
then we
went round the shops, didn't we? And it was just setting up, so just at the right time. So that's the closest thing we got to that. Mm. But yeah, I would like to see it at Disney World as well, but probably won't.
They've got too much else going on there, haven't they?
Yes, of course, 50th anniversary celebrations. I mean, that would have been a good time to bring it back, I would have thought, because it's part of the history.
But... Yeah, but they've got lots of other things going on, haven't they? So.
Yeah.
Yeah. Too much else to worry about.
What do you
about.
Think? Would it be good? Would it have been a good time to bring it back?
Maybe.
And then, moving on. More construction news. Tron, which has basically made the biggest leaps in construction. They're really getting on with it now, so what could that tell us? Are they really open to get it finished in 2021?
That'd
maybe the beginning of 22? It'd be good, wouldn't it?
Yeah. The queues are going to be horrific.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
In there, like as soon as they open up, it's not going to be something that you're going to be able to get on very easily.
No, no. She's getting into character. Normally when the construction speeds up, I think that's normally when they've got their deadline approaching.
Mm.
I think they've got a deadline in their mind, I reckon.
Yeah.
They've not revealed it, but I think they've got
an
ideal date to open.
When they want to open it, yeah.
I suppose they haven't revealed it, so they don't have to commit to it. But...
Well, this is it. So that it'll be more of a surprise. Oh, we've opened it. Surprise.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, there's Tron that's open.
Yeah.
I do kind of hope that it'll be there for when we're there.
Yeah, it'd be nice.
Probably take all day to queue up.
I was going
to
say the queues would be horrendous.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
Something we're used to doing, so.
We'll have to get used to doing it.
Well, yeah. This time round, yeah. Oh, there's nothing to report on Genie Plus this week.
No.
Oh. Can't have a Genie Plus section.
I tried, but could not find anything. It's a bit elusive this week.
Perhaps it's going too swimmingly and people love it.
Yeah, let's just say that.
We'll see. Tune in next week and find out if there's anything there on Disney Genie.
I'm sure there will be, yeah. And then moving on, meet and greets. More good news. So as we reported on our last episode, that meet and greets are coming back. So they're back at the Magic Kingdom and Hollywood Studios.
Yay!
And there's been a few pictures circling around of Mickey dressed in his 50th anniversary attire, set in the 50th anniversary scene. Yeah, and that's at the Town Square Theatre, where he's always has been.
Mm.
So it's good to see that place opening again.
Yeah.
And Alithia, you'll be pleased to know that all your favourite princesses are back in the Princess Fairy Tale Hall.
Yay.
So, with the likes of Tiana, Rapunzel, Cinderella, and Elena of Avalor.
Yay! You get to go see Elena of Avalor.
Yeah.
I can bring my teddy, so she might not want to let go of my teddy.
Unfortunately, at the moment, it's all socially distanced with a rope separating.
So you can't actually go up.
But she'll be able to see your teddy, I'm sure.
You can't go up and hug her, but you can. Yeah, she'll be able to see you, and you can wave and say hello and talk to her.
Or autographs at the moment are not done at the moment, so.
Oh, so that autograph bit we got is completely useless.
Well, hopefully they'll come soon, but you know, we can only hope.
We'll see.
But at least you can talk to them and have your picture taken in front of them, so it's better than nothing. At least you get to see.
I was gonna say
the characters. So. I don't think Disney was Disney without character meets. So
no.
I think it's definitely brought a major element back.
Exactly.
I'm glad to see it back.
So. At least we can still see the characters and,
It does say, obviously, you can still talk to them. So, you know, that's a major part of the character interaction.
Well, yeah,
this
is it,
You know, that might be a good thing. And then, finally, Primeval Will.
Oh, yeah.
Most of you probably seen it in state of disrepair, shall we say. It's been pulled apart. It's pretty much demolished now.
There's some fun pictures up online. Well, I say fun, not so fun, for the Primeval Well. There's just lots of screwed up metal.
I can just imagine a few memes going around. Of that,
What, like the dinosaurs have come and squished it all?
Something like that, yeah. It wasn't everyone's cup of tea. I mean, we never went on it.
I'm glad we didn't.
We've heard even the most hardiest of roller coaster riders, shall we say, found themselves feeling rather queasy after that.
I went on one once at Bridgewater Fair that's very similar,
it
doesn't half throw you about, those kind of things. I think that's probably where the sickness comes from, and where perhaps the reason they've torn it down is because it's a bit too similar to these fairground type things. It's not really, it's more of a, without sounding horrible, like a tacky ride. It's not like up there with the other rides, is there? I know that people loved it, and it's kind of got that fun fair feel to it, but I suppose perhaps in the world of Disney it doesn't quite keep up with their,
it's not like the
theming.
Rest of it now, is it?
There are other rides that have got a similar concept to it, but they're a little bit more smooth.
I mean, Pixar Pier sort of in Disneyland kind of rings the fun fair sort of theme. So
yeah, because they've got the wheel, haven't they? But at
maybe
least
that was a sort of fun fair bit. But
yeah, but at least the wheel, it looks like your sort of London Eye, but it's still got like Disney theming to it. It just seems a bit more.
The big Mickey Mouse on it.
Yeah.
But is it Dinoland USA, wasn't it? I think definitely needs a bit of a Disney facelift. I think they could do something really exciting, like still with the dinosaur theme, I think. But really, you know, sort of go to town on the whole dinosaur theme.
I mean, I suppose when
it's Animal Kingdom.
I mean, the first time, we only ever went in it because we had Alithia, like it looked like something Alithia might enjoy, and also because that's where Donald was to do a Donald meet and greet. So that's we didn't head up in there in 2012. I don't remember going up there.
And I think we only just met Donald and left, didn't we, when we went?
We didn't. We went on
ride. Thing that go up and down with the
like the Aladdin's carpet ride, but
the dino version.
And Alithia danced with Chippendale.
Yeah.
At the disco, you've probably seen it on our vlogs from then. So that, you know, that's kind of cool, keeps to the theming, but actually
keep the best of it like that, but yeah, with a bit more
like
sort
of... the primeval world didn't need to be there, I don't think.
I mean, with the technology of the rides these days, maybe they could do something like really good, like with dinosaurs, like Flights of Passage sort of thing, but immersing you in the world
but
of dinosaurs.
But like a more kid-friendly to keep in with the theme, that it's like a kid's fun, like a fair, like a kid's fair ground, but also, but then also keeping it light-hearted.
I think so. That's what we'd like to see.
Yes, that's our suggestion, Disney, so get on it.
Yeah, start building. But what we will see, who knows? We're obviously knocking down Primeval World for some reason, so what will go in its place?
Do you know what might be going up in there? Let us know if you know.
If you got any guesses as well, let us know. Drop below what you think.
Yeah.
So yeah, that's all we got for this Halloween. We hope you had a good Halloween, what would have been now, by the time you're seeing this, last week.
Yeah.
I hope you enjoyed it.
Yeah.
Oh, actually, one more funny thing that I read the other day.
Oh, go on.
Is, I don't know if you guys read about it as well, is the guy who jumped into the It's a Small World ride to retrieve his phone. In what world is that okay? Well, he just brought the whole ride to a standstill.
Yeah.
Like, there was no need for it. I mean, I know that everyone's attached to their phones, but, like, would you really jump in the water to get your phone?
I wouldn't.
No.
I would probably ask a cast member.
Yeah, you'd flag somebody down and say, I dropped my phone around about here. Can you like get it for me? Because at the end of the day, if it's already gone in the water, depending on what age it is and whether it's waterproof or not, it's done for anyway. Whether you get quickly jump in and after it, if it's touched water, it's done for.
I've dropped mine in the sink before and it survived. So
in a full blown bowl,
sink.
So it's full of water. Oh, okay.
They are supposed to be waterproof for so much.
Well, it depends. Yeah. You might have had like an iPhone 4.
The thing is, at what point of the ride was it? Because although I'm a big Small World fan myself, not everyone likes it, I hear. So I don't know why, but maybe it was like towards the end of the ride and he had enough of the music and he thought, that's it, sploosh.
Oh, well, so you didn't think he actually went for his phone? He was just...
I reckon he just thought he'd have a
diving
swim.
In.
Yeah.
He's bored of the ride.
Can't hear the music under the water.
Maybe.
Who knows?
Maybe.
Things people do for their phones, eh?
We're so attached to them these days, aren't we?
Well, maybe I was going to say, he's probably doing something on Genie.
Maybe.
That's why you got. That's why you still have your phones these days. You got to.
He was doing like a ride interaction.
Yeah.
Maybe.
Anyway, that's all we got for today. We'll catch you again next week with hopefully some more news.
I might dye my hair blonde back. I might dye it back blonde next week. You have to tune in to see. Or I might just keep it like this. What do you think? Do I suit the black look?
With the black lipstick?
Yeah, maybe I'll go full goth. Why not? Shh! It's my real hair. Don't listen to
it. It isn't.
She doesn't know what she's talking about.
She didn't know what she's talking about.
So yeah, tune in to see if I've actually gone the full way with my black hair or whether I'm going to go back blonde.
Yeah, it's not real hair.
So thanks for watching. Thanks for watching, guys. And we'll see you again next week. Don't forget
to like and subscribe.
See you next time.
Bye.
Bye.
Happy Halloween.
Happy Halloween. Oh.